Hello travelers, Boardman21 here, and today got a level 100 build guide for you that's going to be based off the 1 to 75 recent leveling guide we did for the Acolyte to Lich based on Hungering Souls and Death Seal using Death Wave and proccing the Hungering Souls for you. Now, even at level 100, this build can still do really good damage. Death Wave is going to hit for a ton, and your Hungering Souls are going to hit for a ton of damage as well. We built into the one hand and staff, and yet we're still doing amazing damage, even though we're not using a two-handed staff for the adaptive spell damage. But the point of this build, you're leeching a ton, you're proccing tons of Hungering Souls, and you're using Death Wave on Death Seal for a large AoE. The build has great survivability, especially the more life that you have, and you'll use Aura of Decay to heal you for a portion of your missing life. Alright, let's go ahead and get into the skills, the interactions, and just how it all works. For skills, I'm running Death Seal, Summon Skeleton, Aura of Decay, Hungering Souls, and Reaper Form. For Death Seal, we're using this for two things. Death Wave, so that we have a huge AoE that we have about 80% uptime of, and we're also using it to proc Hungering Souls for us so that we don't have to manually cast them, or at least not manually cast them as often, and those will be our single target killers. So we've got 3 points in Moratorium for increased duration, 1 point in Devouring Release so that every second a Hungering Soul will be released. It doesn't matter how you build the Hungering Soul skill tree, this will only release a single Hungering Soul. So your best bet is to spec Hungering Souls into doing the most damage with a single soul, and you'll see that when we get to that skill tree. We have 5 points in Insatiable Soul, so that we now have 160% increased Hunger Soul frequency, which means instead of 1 per second, you're getting about 3 per second now. 5 points in Corrupted Consciousness to increase your damage per percentage of missing health. And then we have 1 point in Moral Pulse, so we'll get the Death Wave every second. 3 points in Tachycardia gives us increased critical strike chance with the Death Wave, and also makes it appear about 1/3 more often. We got 3 points in Desperate Shroud, which gives you armor and stun avoidance per 10 missing health. And 1 point in Deadlock is automatically going to reduce your health to 33% of your maximum so that you'll fall into the low life category. So even if you had full life, once you activate this, you'll be at 33%, which puts you below the 35% low health threshold, and activate anything that you have that's low life, like increased damage from your passives. For Summon Skeleton, we have this set up so that we will summon all 3 of them at once, and so that we have a 3 of them capped max. You can't ever summon more than that. The reason for having 3 of them is that if you have exactly 3 minions out, Hungering Souls does 150% more damage. So you want to have 3 of them active at all times, and we just made it to where you can do it in one cast to make sure that you always have them. So we've got 5 points in Necrotic Conviction, 1 point in Hollow Walkers, 1 point in Dread Phalanx, 1 point in Aegis of Death, 1 point in Bone Armor, 1 point in Impatience, 1 point in Marrow Tap, 2 points in Empty the Graves, 4 points in Unbound Necromancy, 2 points in Unholy Rage, and 1 point in Marrow Walkers. For Aura of Decay, we have this set up to heal you every second for a percentage of your missing health. It's also going to apply Armor Shred instead of applying Poison. This way we don't end up hurting ourselves or killing ourselves and our characters. So what we really want is for it to just take armor off, just so that we can have it active so that it's healing us for a bit of our health that's missing. Now what this does is it'll keep you in Reaper form for a longer period of time. And the more healing effectiveness you have, the longer the period of time that will be. Now we've got 4 points in Plague Rat, 2 points in Inoculation, 4 points in Absence of Life, 1 point in Chilled of the Bone, 1 point in Putrid Bombs, 4 points in Undertow, 3 points in Corrosive Aura, and then the 1 point in Decryptify, which makes it no longer do poison on enemies or yourself. It's now Armor Shred. This will apply Armor Shred to you as well, so if you don't have a lot of armor, you do go negative, and you will end up taking a little bit more damage, but usually that's objective because you will be healed for enough to kind of offset that. For Hungering Souls, we have this set up to fire out 1 projectile, do more damage everywhere that we can get it, and then synergize with the 3 minions. So we've got 1 point in Necrotic Pact, 2 points in Grave Bond, 3 points in Unholy Trinity, which is what gives you that 150% more damage when you have exactly 3 minions, 5 points in Ravenous for more spell necrotic hit damage, 1 point in Isolation to give you exactly only 1 soul, but it's 100% larger and it deals 100% more damage. 4 points in Great Soul for another 100% more damage and 80% size. 2 points in Piercing Gaze and 2 points in Hungering Eyes. Also, the plus 8 mana cost here doesn't matter. When Hungering Souls is proc'd through Deathseal, it doesn't actually cost mana. So this mana cost is only if you manually cast it. Then for Reaper Form, we have the setup just basically to do more damage, and Reaper Form is a free life for you. We've got 2 points in Mistress of Decay, 4 points in Harbinger of Blood, 1 point in Reaper's Ascendance, 3 points in Death Touch Scythe, 4 points in Soul for a Soul, 4 points in Reaper's Curse, and 2 points in Death's Door. For passives, I've got 20 points in the base Acolyte class with 7 points in Blood Aura, 5 points in Blood Pact, and 8 points in Forbidden Knowledge, 0 points in the Necromancer, and then 90 points in the Master Lich, with 10 points in Apocrypha, 5 points in Grasp of Fate, 8 points in Survival of the Cruel, 8 points in Dance with Death, 8 points in Crippling Insight, 8 points in Unclosing Wounds, 8 points in 3 Plagues, 5 points in Deathbringer, 5 points in Dark Guard, 5 points in Clairvoyant Insight, 10 points in Necrotic Energy, 5 points in Ageless Ascetic, and 5 points in Soul Maul for all that extra leech. Alright, for items, idols, uniques, and blessings, there are no uniques required for this build. There are a couple that affect Hungering Souls. I believe there's a wand or a staff that does some damage with it. Soulfire, the unique relic, will convert it to fire. I'm not using either of those. I don't know if the weapon would be okay. I don't want to use Soulfire because we don't want to convert to fire. We want to keep our necrotic damage for both the Hungering Soul and for Deathwave. But if you want to try those out, you definitely can. For idols, we're wearing 4 1x3s that give increased and flat health. And then we have 2 2x2s that give increased healing effectiveness. And as a suffix, you can get anything that you want. But that prefix, increased healing effectiveness, is really going to increase the amount that Aura of Decay is healing you, which is really helpful. For all the crafted items, I'm just going to hover over them. Basically, you want anything that would give you necrotic damage, crit chance, necrotic penetration, give you additional life, give you plus levels to Death Seal or Hungering Souls, whichever is your choice. Those are what are going to help you the most. This, again, will be in the build planner, which is linked in the description below and in the written guide. For blessings, same thing. These blessings are not all best in slot. Feel free to go ahead and get the blessings that you feel would be better for the build. Alright, for the character sheet, we have about 2700 health. We are capped on almost all resistances except for physical, just barely shy on necrotic. We're sitting at about 14% armor, but that will drop down as we have Aura of Decay active and it applies the armor shred on us. And then for damage types, we have about 700% necrotic damage. Now again, we are at low life at this very point, but once we start healing or once we're above that, you will lose a little bit of damage. So with Aura of Decay active, you'll see that we jump back down once we get healed here for a couple of seconds. Yeah, we lost the low life bonus. You'll also notice that we lost a bunch of our armor. However, this armor can be higher, one, when you activate Death Seal, and two, if you take the blessings or put more armor on your gear that allow for more armor. For our other stats, if you activate Reaper Form, you'll notice we gain some damage back, and then once you activate Death Seal, you're going to have a ton of damage as it gives you that huge bonus based on how much life that you're missing. You also gain a bit of armor as well. Alright, and then for how to play the build, skill rotation, I like to put Reaper Form on autocast, make sure Aura of Decay is active, and then just summon your minions. Make sure you always have 3 active. They'll all be summoned at once. If you are missing one, you can resummon and it'll refresh all 3 of them. And then just activate Death Seal, have your Hungering Souls go up. You can manually fire some as well, and you can see it's absolute crazy damage. Now, your tooltip here is about 177,000 per Hungering Soul. That's about what we're hitting the training dummy for, is 177,000. And you're getting 4 of these per second. This isn't taking into account, this is you firing one about every second. This doesn't take into account that you're getting 3 of them per second for free through the use of Death Seal, which is allowing you to do about 700,000 damage per second to the training dummy just from Hungering Souls. And then, of course, you have Death Wave on top of that. So you're almost at a 1 million damage per second build against the training dummy, which is absolutely crazy. Alright, that's going to be it for this build guide. Hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, stay safe and enjoy some gameplay. Pain, an eternity of pain, unchanging. Jesus.
dwarfs, all of you.